Black Panther was an amazing movie for many reasons, but some fans think Danai Gurira as Okoye absolutely stole the show. We all know she's a ferocious member of the Dora Milaje who've sworn loyalty to the Black Panther, but you might be surprised to learn the true role of the Dora Milaje in the comic books and learn who Okoye almost ended up in a relationship with. Okoye is a member of the Dora Milaje, and in Black Panther, we learned that this is an elite group of female warriors sworn to protect the ruler of Wakanda. We don't go to the theater to see the latest Marvel movie because we're hoping for a romantic storyline, but this one was done really well. The love between Okoye and Wakabi actually added to the storyline, made sense for the characters, and did not come out of nowhere. And for a Marvel movie, that's all the more impressive. The studio even filmed a scene which confirmed that Wakabi and Okoye are indeed married, but it didn't end up making it into the final cut of the movie. The deleted scene takes place while Okoye and Wakabi are arguing over whether or not to support Killmonger and his infiltration of Wakanda. Okoye asks Wakabi if he wants her to leave the Dora Milaje and bring their children into the world as conquerors. Wakabi claims their children will be able to lead a truly free world instead of the insular country of Wakanda. As much as we love Okoye, Wakabi, and their relationship, we think it makes sense that Marvel Studios omitted this scene where Okoye seems like she's deferring to her husband's opinion as a wife and future mother. Instead, Okoye initially claims to support the throne regardless of who sits on it out of a deep-rooted respect for Wakandan traditions and her position in the Dora Milaje. But some fans wished that there were more interactions between Okoye and Wakabi. Apparently, there were some signs showing them being physically affectionate with one another, but they didn't end up making it into the final cut of the movie either. However, even without these scenes being included in the movie, most moviegoers were under the impression that Okoye and Wakabi were married because of the way that they were interacting. Their storyline wasn't about falling in love or the thrill of new romance, which makes it different from a lot of movies and Marvel movies in particular. These two characters have been together for a long time, know each other really well, and have a huge amount of respect for one another. In the comic books, Okoye is much more subservient and acts as a potential love interest for T'Challa. In the movie, she has the rank of general and leads the Dora Milaje. It's quite the promotion, and it's awesome to see a man and a woman being such good friends without any romantic overtones. We love Okoye's relationship with Wakabi, but her friendship with T'Challa is great too. Of course, she respects him as a king, but she also knows him well enough to call him out when the situation warrants it, such as when he freezes up around Nakia. In fact, the Okoye we see on the big screen in Black Panther has a very different personality compared to the comic book version of the character. She's a lot more like another character named Anika, who was the captain of the Dora Milaje prior to the events of Black Panther. Anika doesn't exist in the MCU, but Io has been around since the events of Captain America Civil War. Apparently, there was a scene originally intended to be in Black Panther, which hinted at a romance between Okoye and Io. The two were going to be making flirtatious eyes at one another while in formation with their fellow members of the Dora Milaje. Then, the two tell each other they look good. And Okoye replies, "I know. How Han Solo of her." It's unclear whether Okoye and Io were ever going to have an actual romantic relationship in the movie, or if this was just going to be a reference to the comic books, but it's pretty similar to a scene early in the relationship of Anika and Io, where Anika calls Io beautiful. Apparently, this scene didn't make it very far in the production process either, and ended up being scrapped early on. Clearly, they decided to go in a different direction with Okoye's character by having her marry Wakabi. The costumes, hairstyles, and makeup worn by the characters of Black Panther are incredibly impressive. According to Danai Gurira, she spent about an hour and a half per day getting Okoye's head tattoos applied, and that was on a good day. But the Dora Milaje's outfits were another matter entirely, and were influenced by some surprising sources. Most of the costumes from Black Panther were inspired by traditional outfits from various places in Africa. But for the Dora Milaje's outfits, the costume department looked a bit farther east. According to senior visual development illustrator Anthony Francisco, the Dora Milaje costume was only about 80% African influence. For the remainder of the costume, costume, he and his team drew inspiration from Filipino tribal artifacts and other Asian themes. Francisco grew up in the Philippines and often saw African artifacts mixed in with the traditional Filipino decor, but there was one tribe in particular who influenced the costumes, and that was the Ifugao tribe. Their name means people of the earth, which seems fitting for the movie Black Panther. They live in a village at the base of the Cordillera mountain range in the north of Luzon Island. Many people know of their ancient rice terraces, which were built by their ancestors in 100 BC. Historians believe they suggest the ancient Ifugao people had a waste management system which was far ahead of its time. In modern times, the Ifugao people still believe in preserving their cultural elements and take great pride in their weaving, beading, and traditional narrative chants. The beadwork on Okoye's abdomen was inspired by a table runner Francisco would always see when he visited his aunt's house. If you look carefully, you'll see small golden rings hanging from the tassels on the side of her uniform. These are supposed to bring good luck to the wearer. Everyone knows the Dora Milaje are incredible warriors, but a certain part of their costume was influenced by another type of famous elite warrior, the samurai. The split-toed boots worn by samurai were known as jikatabi. They were used as the inspiration for the shoes of the Dora Milaje. Francisco also credits the Maasai in southern Kenya and northern Tanzania for providing inspiration for the uniforms, and their armbands and neck rings are based on those worn by the women of the South African Ndebele tribe. All in all, Francisco claims the Dora Milaje's uniforms are about 5% samurai, 5% ninja, and 5% Ifugao tribe. While Okoye might not have looked very pleased to see so many newcomers showing up during Avengers Infinity War, Danai Gurira says she was ecstatic to get to work with so many other talented actors. It turns out that it wasn't just us Marvel fans who got excited over seeing our favorite characters together all in one movie. There's no denying that Okoye wasn't happy during Infinity War, and we're not just talking about what happened at the end. According to Gurira, Okoye is naturally cautious when it comes to outsiders. She's always thinking about the myriad of ways things could go terribly wrong at any given moment and worrying about what she can and can't control. Although this may make her distrustful, it's also made her an amazing leader and contributed immeasurably to the success of the Dora Milaje. Just like fellow warriors, Okoye has grown up in the Dora Milaje, and fighting to defend Wakanda and her king is her life's work. So although Thanos is the biggest threat of Infinity War, Okoye doesn't exactly trust all of the newcomers right away. So with that in mind, you can probably imagine just how glad Okoye is that Bucky Barnes is in Wakanda. Although it turns out he wasn't actually responsible, it's probable that she spent some time under the impression that he was responsible for the death of T'Chaka, the former king and Black Panther. Oh yeah, then there's that whole Winter Soldier thing where, you know, he spent decades as an incredibly dangerous assassin. Honestly, it would probably be weirder if Okoye did trust Bucky at this point. One of the major points of contention in the movie Black Panther is whether Wakanda should open its borders to outsiders or remain secluded. After all, there's a lot of benefits to the rest of the world thinking that you're an impoverished nation with limited resources. Announcing that you have access to incredible weapons and technology kind of makes you a massive threat. But of course, limiting your visibility also limits your ability to provide assistance to people outside of Wakanda. Over the course of the movie, we saw T'Challa struggling with this conundrum, but it turns out that this is something which has been on Okoye's mind as well. And it makes sense, because even though she wasn't royalty, maintaining the security of Wakanda is her primary objective. How much more difficult does her job become when Wakanda goes public? Gurira says this is something which is frequently weighing on Okoye's mind, and she can't help but think of it when Bucky arrives in Wakanda. We've seen Okoye appear in two MCU movies so far, Black Panther and Avengers Infinity War. She's scheduled to appear in Avengers Endgame as well, since she was one of the people left standing after Thanos' decimation. But what about her future in the MCU? Black Panther was a massive success at the box office, so we know it's only a matter of time before Marvel officially announces the release date for a sequel, but because this is Marvel Studios we're talking about, we're sure they'll make us wait as long as possible for any details. According to Gurira, don't expect Okoye to be moving into Avengers headquarters anytime soon. Although we've seen her venture outside of Wakanda, her responsibility is ultimately to her home. She'll go where her king chain commands and fight by his side, but don't expect her to make the move from Wakanda. Okoye may seem indestructible, but she's well aware of how much she's got on her plate. Guarding another person is a heavy task, especially when that someone is the Black Panther. Most of the superheroes in the Marvel lineup are concerned about saving the world as a whole, but Okoye's mostly focused on one small piece of the world, and that's Wakanda. During Infinity War, we saw the fight taken to her doorstep and the ferocious way she responded as a result. It's safe to say that, having gone public, Wakanda will likely become an extremely important place in the MCU, and we'll be seeing much more of Okoye. What do you think about the character Okoye from Black Panther and Avengers Infinity War? Do you wish any of the deleted scenes made their way into the final cut of Black Panther? Let us know in the comment section below, and don't forget to subscribe to CBR for more MCU content. Thanks for watching.